So the Spring approach to building operating system is to adopt strong interfaces for each subsystem. What that means is the only thing that is exposed outside a subsystem is what services are provided by that subsystem, but not how. In other words, the how part of it can be changed at any time so long as the external interface remains unchanged. So that is what is meant by strong interfaces. And this naturally leads to object orientation. And they also wanted to make sure that the system is open and flexible. And this is important if you're an operating system vendor and you want to integrate third-party software into your operating system. You want to make sure that your interfaces are open and flexible. And at the same time, you want to maintain the integrity of your subsystems. And that's why strong interfaces are extremely important. And being open and flexible also suggests that you don't want everything to be written in one language. You don't want to be tied to a particular language for implementing all the system components. And this is the reason that in Spring, they chose to use IDL, which is the interface definition language. And this is from the OMG group. There are IDL compilers that are available from several third-party software vendors. And what that allows you to do is you can define your interfaces using IDL, and third-party software vendors can use that IDL definition of the interfaces and use them in building their own subsystems that can integrate with the Spring system. And the other part of a Spring approach is extensibility. And extensibility naturally leads to microkernel-based approach. And that's what you see here. This is the structure of the Spring system. And what you see below this red line is Spring's idea of a microkernel. And in fact, there are two parts to it. There is a nucleus, which in Spring is the entity that provides the abstractions of threads and inter-process communication among the threads. And the kernel itself is made up of nucleus plus the virtual memory manager. So if you put these two things together, the nucleus gives you threads and IPC, and the VM manager gives you memory management. And if you remember back to our good old friend Liedtke's principle of what a microkernel should provide, you see that what is below this red line is exactly Liedtke's principle. That is, the microkernel is providing the abstraction of threads and IPC and an abstraction of memory. And everything else is outside the kernel. All the things that are above the red line are outside the kernel. And in particular, I mentioned that Spring is Sun Microsystems' answer to building a network operating system, because this is a time when transitioning was happening to services that are being provided on the network. And so they wanted to go from an operating system that runs on a single node to a network operating system using the same interface, namely the Unix interface. And so this entity that you see here, which is called the network proxy, we'll see that more of it in later discussion in this lesson. This is the entity that allows machines to be connected to one another. All the ovals that you're seeing that are outside the kernel provide different services that you might need in your desktop environment. For instance, an X11 server is a display manager, and you may need ability to do shell level programming, and you need file system, and you need a way by which you can communicate on the network, meaning that you need a protocol stack.